In the tunnel where I was raped, in a tunnel that was once an underground entry to an amphitheatre, a place where actors burst forth from underneath the seats of a crowd, a girl had been murdered and dismembered. I was told this story by the police. In comparison, they said, I was lucky. On the day of the rape to the hospital, I let myself collapse. I went somewhere deep inside myself, curled up and away from what was happening. They rushed me through the emergency room doors, then into an examination room. I couldn't help but think of detective shows on television. The nurse and policeman argued over me as he began to ask questions, take my clothes for evidence as she swabbed my face and back with alcohol and promised me the doctor would be there soon. I knew my life was over. My life had just begun. After telling the hard facts to anyone from lover to friend, I have changed in their eyes. Often it is awe or admiration. Sometimes it is repulsion. Once or twice it has been fury hurled directly at me for reasons I remain unsure of. Since then I've always thought that under rape in the dictionary it should tell the truth. It is not just forcible intercourse. Rape means to inhabit and destroy everything. I lost my virginity and almost my life when I was raped. I also discarded certain assumptions I had held about how the world worked and about how safe I was. On July 13, 1982, in a court, my assailant was sentenced. It was the maximum for rape and sodomy. 8 1/3 to 25 years, the largest sentences, along with lesser ones given for the all remaining charges, would run concurrently. I had reached some positive ground zero, the world was new and open to me. This is my story, I'm Alice Sebold. What would you do if you were beaten and raped? Would you try to fight for your right and bring criminals to justice, or just choose escape and move on with your life? We all live in a world where two truths coexist, where both hell and hope lie in the palm of our hand. Don't be afraid, I wish you all a long and happy life.